7th December 2021 मॉर्निंग मुरली ओम शांति बप्तादा मधुपन स्वीट चिल्ड्रन द फादर द कॉन्करर ऑफ हार्ट्स हैज कम टू विन द हार्ट्स ऑफ योर चिल्ड्रन देयरफॉर बिकम दोज विद क्लीन हार्ट्स क्वेश्चन ऑन व्हाट मेन बेसिस इज अ गोल्डन एज स्टेटस क्लेम्ड आंसर ऑन प्योरिटी द मेन थिंग इज प्योरिटी Explain to those who come to the center. If you don't become pure, the knowledge will not stay in your intellect. If while studying yoga you become impure, everything will be ruined. If someone doesn't remain pure, it doesn't matter if he doesn't come to class. You mustn't be concerned about that. To the extent that someone studies and became pure, to that extent he will become wealthy. Song. At last day for which we had been waiting has come. Om Shanti. Your spiritual children know that day has now come again. Which day? Only your children know that the original eternal deity religion of heaven is once again being established in Bharat. That is the kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan is being established. So your children should be so happy that the purifier father to whom you have been calling out has come. He alone is the liberator and guide and the remover of sorrow and the bestower of happiness. After he had liberated you, how did you become trapped again? No one knows this. It takes so much effort to explain to human beings who have such stone intellects. Look what duty he has been given. Come and clean the dirty, impure clothes. Both souls and bodies of deities only are both pure. In the kingdom of Ravan, no one's body can be pure. The bodies are impure. No one knows those things. Perhaps when a soul is pure, he is able to make an impression. However, souls have to become impure. The unlimited father, the purifier, comes and says, "These five vices are devilish. Renounce them. If you don't listen to me, you will be harassed by Dharmaraj, the supreme judge. If you don't listen to the almighty authority, there will be very severe punishment from Dharmaraj. The father has come to purify you. You know you were pure deities and have now become impure. So you must instantly let go of that. Body consciousness is the devil's dictates and this also has to be renounced. The number one vice has to be renounced. A day will come when impure beings will not be able to sit with the father in this gathering. No one impure will be allowed. Remove the dirty impure ones from here. They won't be allowed to enter the court of Indra. Then, no matter how wealthy or whatever else someone may be, they won't be able to enter. Everything may be explained to them outside, but they wouldn't be allowed to come in. Now they are allowed to come so they can be tempted, but not later on. If Baba hears that an impure person is sitting here, Baba won't like it. There are many such ones who come and sit here secretly. Such ones will have to experience a lot of punishment. People go to the temples and religious places only after bathing. No one would go there without bathing. That is physical bathing. This is the bathing of knowledge. One has to be pure in this too. Even non-vegetarians are not allowed to come. When the time comes, Baba will become strict. Look how strong the path of devotion is in the world. Those who read a lot of scriptures receive a title of Shastri, means degree in the Sanskrit language. What would you do by learning Sanskrit, etc.? The father says, forget everything. Simply remember the one father and you will become pure and the masters of the land of Vishnu. When you have understood this very well, you will forget all the scriptures, etc. People study to become barristers, etc. But the study which the knowledgeful Supreme Soul comes and teaches you is the highest of all. People say to him, O purifier, come. However, they don't know they are impure. Baba continues to explain that the Golden Age is called Kingdom of Ram and the Iron Age is called Kingdom of Ravan. At this time, all are impure. The pure deity idols are worshipped in the temples and impure people go and bow down in front of them. This proves that those deities are the highest of all in their purity. They are even higher than the sannyasis. Temples are not built to sannyasis. Now that people have gone into Tamavridhan devotion, they keep pictures of those people. It is called Tamavridhan devotion, the worship of human beings and the five elements. When devotion was Satapradhan, it was the worship of one. That is called unadulterated devotion. He is the one who made the deity so elevated. Therefore, worship should also be of only the one. However, this drama is predestined. Everyone has to go through the stages of Satapradhan, Sato, Raju and Tamo. It is the same here. Some became Satapradhan, some became Sato, some became Raju and others became Tamo. There is first class cleanliness in the Golden Age. Bodies have no values there. The electricity is switched on and they are destroyed. They wouldn't even throw the bones into the river, etc. They wouldn't even pick bodies up and take them somewhere else. There is no question of any difficulty. As soon as the electricity is switched on, they are finished. Here, people cry over bodies. They continuously remember them and also feed Brahmin priests. None of those things will exist there. Everything has to be done with the intellect. What will exist there? Just imagine what heaven will be like. This is hell, the land of falsehood. This is why Maya is false. The body is false and the world is false. As remembered, the government says, stop slaughtering cows. Write to them, the slaughter is much worse. Stop the slaughter of using the sword of lust on one another. Lust is the greatest enemy. It causes sorrow from its beginning through the middle to the end. Conquer it, become pure, and you will become the masters of the pure world. There the deities have new blood. It is said children here have new blood. However, how could there be new blood here? This is old blood. In the Golden Age where you receive new bodies, there will be new blood. These bodies are old and the blood is also old. This is why they have to be renounced. You have to become pure. No one apart from the Father can purify you. Everyone's religion is different. They all have to study their own religious scripture. The Gita is the main one in Sanskrit. The Father says, I don't teach in Sanskrit. I only explain to you in whatever language this Brahma knows. If I were to speak in Sanskrit, how would your children understand? It is not the language of deities. Sometimes daughters come and speak the language of another place. By learning languages, some earn hundreds of thousands and some earn millions for their livelihood. Here, you are earning so much. You know that you will become emperors and empresses in the Golden Age. The more you study, the wealthier you will become. There is a difference between the poor and the wealthy. Everything depends on purity. Explain to those who come to the centers. If you don't remain pure, the knowledge will not stay in your intellect. If after coming to take knowledge for 5 to 7 days, you became impure, the knowledge will be finished. If while studying yoga, you became impure, everything will be ruined. If someone is unable to remain pure, it doesn't matter if he doesn't come here. You shouldn't be concerned about that. Each of you has a burden of the sins of many births on your head. How can that be removed without your having remembrance? Liberation and life in a second has been remembered. Do whatever the Father says. The whole world calls out, "Oh, purifier, come." We are impure. However, no one becomes pure and no one can return home. Those people consider the Brahma element to be God and they remember that. No one has the knowledge of who God is. Neither is Brahma God, nor can anyone merge into the Brahma element. Nevertheless, everyone has to take rebirth because souls are imperishable. The belief that Buddha went back home. However, he would definitely have to sustain what he established. Otherwise, who would sustain it? How could he go back home? You don't say you will go and sit in liberation for all time. You know, you are establishing your own religion. You will then also sustain it. That religion was pure, but everyone has now become impure. Only those who belong to this religion will come. The sampling is being planted. The sweetest tree is of the deity religion. The task of its establishment is being carried out. All the scriptures, etc., that have been created are for the path of devotion. It is the praise of Baba alone that he comes and changes human beings into deities. Therefore, remember very well the Father who makes you become like that. You also know that according to the drama, the path of devotion has to continue. In fact, the best way of salvation for all is one. Therefore, only one should be worshipped. Having taken 84 births, the deities who were Satupradhan have become Tamupradhan. You now have to become Satupradhan again. You can only become that by having remembrance of Baba. No one except the Father has the power to make you that. You just have to remember the one. This is unadulterated remembrance. To remember many is adulteration. Each one of you souls know that Shiv is your Baba. This is why wherever you look, you see them worshipping Shiv. They even place an image of Shiv in front of the deities. In fact, deities don't worship anyone. It is remembered, everyone remembers God at times of sorrow, but in happiness, no one remembers him. Therefore, how could the deities worship anyone? That is wrong. They should not be shown falsely giving praise. They, means the deities, don't even know Shri Baba, that they would remember him. So that picture should be removed. Instead, you should show the image of the worshippers with single crown. None of the sages or holy men have a crown of light. This is why even Brahmins cannot be shown with a crown of light. Those who pay full attention to knowledge will continue to make these corrections. No one has become free from making mistakes. Mistakes continue to be made. The picture of the Trimurti is so good. That is the Father and this is Dada. Baba says, remember me and you will become this. Become soul conscious. The soul says, I don't have attachment to anyone except the Father. While living here, we remember the land of peace and the land of happiness. The land of sorrow now has to be renounced. However, until our new home is ready, we have to live in the old one. We have to become worthy of going to the new home. When souls become pure, they will go home. It is so easy. The main thing to be understood is who God is and who Dada is. The Father gives the inheritance through this one. Baba says, children, Manmanabhav, remember me and you will become pure deities in the golden age. Everyone else stays in the land of liberation at that time. Only the Father takes all souls to the land of peace. It is so easy. Your children should have a lot of happiness. Let your hearts be very clean. It is said, when your heart is clean, all your desires are fulfilled. The heart is in the soul. The true beloved is the father of souls. The father is called the conqueror of hearts, the one who wins your heart. He comes to win everyone's heart. He comes and wins everyone's heart at the confluence age. The supreme soul is the one who wins the hearts of souls. Whereas human beings win the hearts of human beings. In the kingdom of Ravan, they all hurt the feelings of one another. The picture of the Trimurti was also explained to your children in the previous cycle, and this is why it has emerged now too. So it definitely has to be explained. So many pictures have now been created with which one can explain. The picture of the ladder is very good. In spite of that, people don't understand it. Oh, people of Bharat, you are the ones who have taken 84 births. This is not your final birth. We only speak good things. Why do you say that you have not taken 84 births? In that case, you won't go to heaven. You would then come again in hell. They don't want to go to heaven. Bharat has to become heaven. This is an account that has to be understood. Maharatis can explain it very well. There has to be enthusiasm for doing service, for making a donation to someone. If someone doesn't have any wealth, he wouldn't think about donating. First of all, ask them, with what desire have you come here? There is no question of having a glimpse, means of a guru here. Claim unlimited happiness from the unlimited father. There are two fathers. Everyone remembers the unlimited father. Come and understand how you receive the unlimited inheritance from the unlimited father. Only those who are to understand this will understand it. If that person is someone who is going to claim the kingdom, he will understand instantly. The father says, by living at home and doing everything, simply remember Baba. For it is only by remembering him that your sins will be erased. Achha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Baptada. The spiritual father says Namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says Namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point. Never hurt the feelings of others. Have the enthusiasm to do service. If you have the wealth of knowledge, you must definitely donate it. Second point. Make yourself worthy of going to the new home. Make yourself the soul pure with the power of remembrance. Blessing. May you be incorporeal and use all your ornaments with your own stage to overcome all adverse situations. Explanation. Those who keep all their ornaments can never have arrogance of their bodies. To be incorporeal and use all your ornaments is to be Manmanabhav and Madhyajibhava. When you are stable in your own original stage, you can easily overcome all adverse situations. And all your different old types of nature will finish by doing this. When you see the intentions of yourself, the soul, all things of conflict of nature finish. You can then develop in yourself the power to face all situations. Slogan. Take one step just in thought and the father will take 1000 steps of giving cooperation. Om Shanti.